apocalypse alone. So you make friendships, you perform tasks together. You figure out who you need to ride out the chaos and who's expendable. Today, we're gonna split into three teams, go out and search for food. The number each of you picked decides your teammate.
Number one all the way, baby. Yeah.
You and me, baby, all the way.
Who's got a number two?
Well, I did a number two back at the gas station. Come on, dude, that was funny.
Oh, sweet.
I guess you and me are a team. Hello?
All right, boys and girls, it's the end of the world, and the odds are against you from the start. Radiation poisoning is a reality. That's why you're all wearing these. Every day you'll be given a radiation elimination card, and one of them is already contaminated. At the end of the day, the player holding the simulated radiated card is dead. Don't worry, it just means you're disqualified. But you have a chance to survive the day by giving your card to another player and surviving the radiation elimination. It's a test of your personal will, your endurance, and fate. And in the apocalypse, your fate can change like that. Wild animals, bacterial infection, and post-apocalyptic crazies are all around you, waiting to take you down. They're represented by these. We call them twists of fate. They are survival challenges, and dozens of them are scattered all over the playing area. You trigger the motion sensor, and you hear this. Instructions on the back explain your survival challenge. Accomplish the challenge, and you earn the right to take your radiated card and give it to any player you choose and automatically survive the day. We are going to assemble back here at 1800 hours and see who will perish in the chaos and who is one step closer to $100,000. Good luck to all of you. Remember, you have to work as a team to survive the game. But only one of you can be the ultimate survivalist after the apocalypse.